Tell me about the project and what you liked about it when you first read for it.
At first, I couldn't figure out what character I was playing, because it was a guy with a 18-year-old daughter, Boston Southie cop, and he said, "No, that lead is your role." And I go, "Wow, okay, great." And it freaked me out. And it was at the start of all of the racial stuff that started going on. He's torn between his tribe and what he grew up with, which was Irish Catholic Mafia, and his moral character, wanting to do the right thing, to show his daughter what the right thing, to show the next generation what is the right thing. And he's kind of the only person in his tribe that has empathy and can actually put empathy into action and walk the walk.
When I read the script, I just fell in love with the character because she's so complex. And the movie, the story we tell in that movie is amazing. It's so important, especially today. You know, I mean, it's been important forever. And I think we still have to tell that story to people. The more people we talk about, the better. I hope it's going to touch people's hearts.
I know that's not a Massachusetts accent that I'm hearing over here. So where were you from originally, and how did you end up coming over here to do this movie?
Well, I'm from Russia, Siberia, but in the movie I'm doing a German accent. So, yeah, it was kind of interesting to study that accent, because people would think Russian and German, they're kind of close, but they're not. So, yeah, I had to work very hard to do that.
So how do you do that? How do you prepare for all the different types of accents and dialects that are out there?
Well, you have people that will help you to do that. So, and I had a friend from Germany. She actually recorded the whole script for me, and I was trying to mimic her and say the words how she would say.
Tell me a little bit about the film and how this project all came about.
Well, it's about Boston in 1974. It's about the forced busing issue, and the premise of the movie is it's about a Boston Irish cop in South Boston who is assigned to protect the black kids going into South Boston High in 1974, because during the forced busing thing. So it's a pretty intense film.
Having been from here, I remember that time very well. Very difficult time. And so as far as directing it, anything in particular, any particular challenge that you dealt with as you're putting this thing together?
Well, it's interesting, because I had my own experience back in 1974. I was just a little kid. My dad was a civil rights activist, so we had some issues. So it brought back a lot of memories for me that when I was making it, I had to get over that personal issue there in order to portray everyone sort of, you know, in a sort of an honest fashion kind of thing.
Say hello to the people down in New Bedford and Fall River, Massachusetts.
All right. Hey, guys. I grew up in Provincetown, so I'm part Portuguese by association.
Right, right down there in Cape Cod, right?
Yeah.
All right, so tell me about this project. Do you remember, you know, if you were from...
I was nine in 1974, and I remember... I mean, I was just a kid at the time, but I remember watching the footage that was on the TVs, because my mother was very obsessed with following all the shenanigans that were going on. And just being very intimidated and disturbed, really not my nine-year-old brain, I wasn't quite able to comprehend it. But my best friend at the time was a black Portuguese kid named Rodney DeRosa. And I just couldn't figure out why there were such tensions between white and black. It made no sense to me at all. Wanting to be very much be Portuguese, but I wasn't.
Well, you're speaking to a lot of Portuguese right now down at home, because we have a big...
And New Bedford, yeah.
In fact, my name is Santo, so...
okay, all right, yeah. I was one of the few non-Portuguese kids in the school system then. And, I grew up wanting to be Portuguese.
So. Well, we'll welcome you in. We'll welcome you in the club.
I'm honorary.
Honorary member. Yeah. So, you know, being a producer and stuff like that, all the work that goes behind the scenes to put a project like this together, a lot of people don't realize what goes into it.
Well, hell of a lot goes into it. I'll tell you, it's not a particularly glamorous job until you show up at the premiere, and then it's black tie and it looks like it's a fun time. But, I mean, this was a very intense story, and we really wanted to tell it well. I had to prep it, you know, very extensively and make sure everything was right and told properly. And the director, Dan Adams, did a terrific job.
Right, right. What do you got coming up down the road? Are you working on something already?
Yeah, I produce and direct. I just finished directing a film called The Minute You Wake Up Dead, starring Morgan Freeman and Cole Hauser. So that'll probably be out late fall.
What's it like working with people like that, that are well-known household names like that?
You know, I mean, for me, it's like, you know, it's obviously a total honor and like a bucket list, you know, legend to work with, you know. But, you know, listen, when it's going well, you know, and you're surrounded by great talent, it can be like an awesome experience.
The story's been told in a documentary form, but people need to know the inner story from Boston and the theater storm so it can reach the world more. Because it's been like a quiet, it's been like a hush, like been swept underneath the rug for years, so it needs to be brought up and history needs to be told. It's historic.
So writing it, you know, how challenging was it to actually put it into like the written word and stuff like that?
Well, it wasn't challenging. It was more of a feeling. I was 8 years old, 74.
And you grew up where?
Dorchester.
Oh, no.
Dorchester,
kidding.
Right, yeah. Westfield Street. Washington Street.
Shout out.
Right, that's right.
So do you remember a little bit of it? You were in first grade, but you have some memory?
No, I remember. I have a lot of memory of it. I mean, everybody that's from Boston know how it was. You don't go Savin Hill. You don't go Columbia Point. You know what I mean? You got your boundaries away. You don't get off Andrew Station. It was, you know, the city was very sectioned. It was sectioned off. You know what I mean? So
it must be sort of like a fulfilling feeling that you have, that you're able to participate in this project.
Absolutely. Very fulfilling. Nice. Extremely fulfilling.
All right, so
it's a blessing.
Tell the folks why they should see this movie.
Why? Because it come from within the community, not from outside the community. I was there. My family was there. People that's involved care about the project. The background of the story, when y'all see it, you're going to understand why you should be there. Because it's like Coda. Shout out to Coda. Great movie. It's a movie like that where it came from within the characters. You know what I mean? It's telling from the heart of the characters how people felt within that moment. It gives a good example of that. So,
did you ever have to learn the Boston accent? That's a tough one, isn't it?
It is a very tough. So, yeah, I tried and, we decided better to keep her more German.
Well, we wish you much success. It's a very interesting project and a very powerful project. We wish you all the success in the world.
Thank you so much.